point, the boundary is equidistant from a point, O, let us say O, if O is the point which is equidistant from all the points on the boundary, then O is said to be the center of the circle. If we have a circle of this radius R, then when radius is R, then area is equal to pi R squared. Now suppose I have to find the area of a circle of radius 7 cm. Area will be equal to pi R squared, that is 22 by 7 into 7 into 7. Again, I will, this 7 will cancel out and the answer will be 7 to the 14, 1 carry, 7 to the 14 and 1, 154 centimeter square. Right? To find the area of a circle, we have to put the value of pi. Pi is a constant and it is considered as 22 by 7 and it has another value of pi is also equal to 3.14. According to the question, whatever value is given for the pi, we will use that value. But if no value is given, we will assume that we will use the value 22 by 7. Right? Suppose this was a direct question in which the radius was given and we were supposed to find the area. Now it can be made complicated by saying that we are given the diameter. First, I would like to tell you what is the diameter. Diameter is a straight line passing through O and joining the two ends of the The two ends are on the circumference of the circle, suppose AB. Now AB is the diameter as it is passing through O and it is touching both the ends. A and B are touching the circle. So in this case, this diameter is, for example, I have been given that diameter is 14 centimeters. Then first I would like to find the radius, which is 14 upon 2, that is 7 cm. And now when I have found the radius, I can use this formula again to find the area of a circle. Right? This type of questions, this type of concept, yeah, or we can say this type of formula can be used in all the questions where we are supposed to find the area of a circle, maybe area of a wheel or any circular object where radius is being given. To make the question complicated, it can be asked in the opposite sense. That means it can be given that we have an area of 154 cm square and we are supposed to find the radius. Now, as in this question, I have taken the radius as 7 cm and I have calculated the area as 154 cm square. It can be the other way around, that I have been given the area as 154 cm square and I am supposed to find the radius of the circle. As no radius has been given, I will take radius as x centimeter. Now area will be equal to pi x square, or I can say pi x square is equal to 154 centimeter square, or x square is equal to 154 upon pi. So it will be equal to 154 up into 7 upon 22. Let us cut it with and I will get 7. So it will be 49. X square is 49. So X will be 7 centimeter. 7 centimeter. Right? So a direct question can be asked where the radius have been given and we are supposed to find the area. Or we can say the diameter is given, we will first find the radius and then the area. The other way around it can be that the area has been given to us and we are supposed to find the radius of the object or maybe the diameter of the object. In both the cases, we will first find the radius. Let us, we will assume the radius as x centimeter and then area will be pi x square. Pi x square will be equal to 154 cm square. X square will be this and so other we will get x as 7 cm. Right? Now suppose we were supposed to find the diameter of the circle, then we will double the radius because diameter is 2 times radius. And as I have found that radius is 7 cm, I will multiply it with 2 and the diameter will be 14 cm. Right?